This is not one of your motion pictures.
What's up, guys? Present day Sub-Zero here, coming at you with the video from the archive. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope you guys enjoy. All right, what's up, guys? So today's topic is on Pop Smoke. So first thing I want to say is rest in peace to Pop. Man, gone way too soon. Only 20 years old, younger than me. And I just don't understand why. Like, what was the motive behind it? Like, at the time of this recording, it was based on, or people think it's based on, just somebody set him up or robbery. And like, from what I read, the robbers didn't take anything. They just, I don't know what they wanted, but either way, like, there was no reason for them to kill somebody. And then on top of that, he got killed in Cali, but he's from New York. So, I mean, that's just crazy to me, because I don't even know. I know he was renting a house in Cali and had a party before he got killed, like that night before he got killed. So, yeah, I don't know if the robbers were maybe at the party, but then I also saw that he flashed his address of where he was staying that night on live, I think the day before. So it's just crazy. It's crazy to just the dude just came out. Like, I just heard about him last year, thanks to No Jumper Adam 22. But yeah, like, before that, I never heard of him. But once I started listening to him, I was like, damn, this shit kind of dope. Like, and I fuck with grime music, which is like UK's rap, essentially, based on my understanding. But yeah, and like, that's why I fuck with him, was because it reminded me of that UK style rap, and I fuck with their shit. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna continue listening to him because I fuck with this and I fuck with grime. So I'm like, all right, yeah. I think it's gonna be something I could vibe with for sure. And it was just new. Like, I feel like New York rappers weren't really on that type of style. They didn't have that style. But once him and I think it's Favo or Fivo, or yeah, once they started coming around with that type of music, then everybody else was on that drill type music. But I fuck with it. So I would consider him the pioneer of that style of rapping as far as in New York, because from people I've heard, nobody was really rapping like Pop. So I definitely got to give it up to him, because he definitely created a movement, and I hope people continue it and keep it going, because that's going to be the next thing. That's going to be the next thing. So, but yeah, and I saw, I think, Joey Badass and Lil TJ dropped a song for him, like, based around him. And well, later on in the video, we're going to do a little reaction video to the song, and I'm going to let you guys know what I think about it, and we're going to go from there. As black men, we have to do better. We have to. Like, since day one, we already had a target on our back, and now we just giving them a reason to have a target on our back. So we got to change everything. We got to change the whole vibe, the music, everything. We need to stop promoting drugs, gangs, and women, sex, all of that. Like, come on, we so much better than that. Like, we not all basketball players, we not all musicians. Like, look, we gotta have some doctors, we gotta have some engineers. Like, let's create a car. Let's make a car. Like, I personally don't know of any black-owned automotive companies. Not yet. And eventually I'll go look into it. But I want to see a black person have a car company and it be out there like Nissan, Toyota, GMC. I want to see that at the forefront. I want to see that in America too. And I'm sure maybe in other places there's black-owned vehicles, but I want to see those vehicles in America too. And not even just vehicles. I want to see everything. I want to see that black people can do other things besides be athletes or musicians, because we got a lot of talent, so we just got to show the world our talents and put them out there. But yeah, we gotta change. We gotta do different. We gotta bring some more positivity to our culture. And like, I know it's not all negativity, and we do have a lot of positive things about us. We do have a lot of positive things going on as far as like streetwear, street art, some of the music like J. Cole, Kendrick, all those kind of things. So we just need more of it. And that's really all it's about. More positivity, more helping each other out, putting each other on, not killing each other, not selling each other drugs, not selling drugs at all. But yeah, we can do it. We can do it. We can do that for sure. So we just got to stick with it and put everybody on. That's it. That's it. And then once all that positivity starts to happen, oh, things are going to change for sure. For sure. So, yeah, that's just one step of the process that we have to do in order to better ourselves and our culture and our name, too. So, let's start today. So I got my phone here, and we're going to take a listen to Lil TJ Forever Pop.
Every day I walk with it, that's why I can't leave the crib without it. The day I ever get caught slipping, boy, I doubt it. But then you never know, nigga. You never know when it's your time to go, nigga. I know I ain't.
Alright, so I'm gonna pause it there. First thing he said, whenever he leaves the house, he got it. So, like, I don't understand what he's saying, but it's still like, man, y'all got money now, like, higher security. And like someone told me, whatever you get out of the world, whatever you put in it. So that's the thing, is just start being more positive and not putting yourself out there. Like, you're not going to see J. Cole get shot. J. Cole doesn't do anything to make himself a target or put a target on his head in order for people to want to kill him. J. Cole can literally just go walk on the street and nobody will bother him negatively. They may bother him as a way of like asking for pictures and stuff, but like for certain people, y'all, certain people can't go and walk on the street by themselves because they've now put a target on their head. So in order to change that, let's spread a little bit more positivity. Let's not gloat. Let's not be cocky or anything like that. And just keep spreading that positivity, and you will receive that positivity back and not have to feel like you got to look over your shoulders whenever you go out or anything like that. If you're not chilling with your boys, you feel like you can't go anywhere because you don't know what's going to happen to you that day.
Ain't satisfied with this, I'm trying to go bigger. I ain't laying nothing in my way, I've been a go-getter. I can't even get this through my mind, how you go, nigga? I always told you I just wanna see you go, nigga. Rest my nigga Pop Smoke, know I'm letting shots go at any nigga. Fuck it, I inherited the ops, bro. You know I'm finna make it to the tippy-tippy top, bro, for you. I know that's what you wanna see me do. Can't believe shit, can't can't believe this shit is true. Took you out your glory, who the one to see you lose? Woke up in the morning, see my nigga on the news. And I'm still like, damn, trying to put together screws. Taking deep breaths, recording this, I'm busting out in deep sweat. Mind froze, like I don't even got a reflex. Said a lot, but still, it feel like I ain't even speak yet. Trying to hit a pocket that I still ain't even reach yet. And I still can't comprehend this shit, it hit me.
So he said he's trying to reach a pocket that he ain't... let me rewind this again for us. Trying to hit a pocket that I ain't even reach yet. And like, that just goes to show you, like, there's so much more out there for you to accomplish. Like, it's not over. Once you hit that mill, you got 2 mil, 10 mil, 20 mil, a billion. Just keep raising that limit. Don't ever stop. The grind's never over. Always push yourself to do more because there is always more to do and accomplish. So keep on grinding.
Still can't comprehend this shit. It hit me in the heart. Man, I seen it from the start. Put a 3-5 in my word to try to shift my mind apart. It's different now, I know I always gotta move smart. We can't change now, we gon' let your name ring. A lot of niggas, they won't feel it, still gang bang. I know how it feel to lead them trenches, did the same thing. Just trying to provide for mama love and help her maintain.
Hold on, I think I missed another key part in this song. So let's take it back again.
I seen it from the start. Put a 3-5 in my word to try to shift my mind apart. It's different now, I know I always gotta move smart. We can't change now, we gon' let your name ring. A lot of niggas, they won't feel it, still gang bang. I know how it feel to lead them trenches, did the same thing. Just tryna provide for mama love and help her maintain.
I know how it feel to leave them trenches. So remember that. Like, I saw somebody said, a rapper said, don't leave New York. But like, yeah, I mean, hell, if you don't want to leave, shit, who want to leave New York? I ain't gonna lie, the weather bad as shit. But other than that, like, if that's your home and that's where you want to be, stay. But don't stay somewhere where you can potentially get hurt or die. If you can die, I probably wouldn't stay there. So me personally, if I wanted to stay in New York, I would stay in a better part of New York and just be able to move a lot easily without having to worry about, oh, I don't know that dude. I don't know what he doing. I don't know who he with, stuff like that. So that's what I take that as, is like move to better circumstances for yourself. That's all.
Give like a message to my young niggas, you feel me? Like niggas like us, from where we come from, we can't afford to fuck up. We can't afford to slip up and make no mistakes, you heard? Because they watching and they want us to. You know what I'm saying? We got all odds against us.
That's facts. And I'm telling you, like, I literally just said this at the beginning of the day, like, we were at the bottom from day one. So we just got to push ourselves to be better and to show people, hey, we could do more than what they expect out of us. And then it's going to be a lot of work, and it's a lot harder for us than it is for a lot of other people. So we got to put in that work to better ourselves and show them, yeah, we can get out of here and we can do better. Fuck with this song. I like it. I like it for sure. And it just shows you, like, there's so much more out there and your life's not over. Like, you can be doing so much more and you should be doing so much more. Stop settling for, oh, this is okay. Like, always push yourself to do better. Always. So now we're going to check out Joey Badass's song. All right. So I got Joey Badass's song here. Well, it's not really a song, it's just a freestyle, but it's on his Instagram if you want to check it out.
Yo, it's just some shit that I wrote. I ain't explaining this shit. Bye. Yeah. Time waits for no man. Life is but a two-step slow jam.
Right off the bat, hard. Time waits for no man. So stop wasting your time doing senseless things or just bringing that negativity into the world. Why not just bring positivity into the world and you will get it back? That's all it takes. You spread the positivity and it will come right back to you. That's the good side of karma. So why not do that? Damn. Already spinning.
So with the devil trying not to lose my balance. God bless the kid with many talents. He was chosen. Why you see him living in the moment? Every second gotta own it. Cause you never know what could be your last. Time breathing, now you bleeding from the gun blast. And you thinking about your past. See your whole life in a flash. Best friends, love in your casket. Now your son the best. Pressure on his shoulders, make him gotta grow fast. Where I'm from, the story nothing end with no happily ever afters. Just broken families, forced to start new chapters. A natural disaster, cycle in the loop, and we caught up in a rapture.
On top of that, like, if you have a kid, you have a wife, but you spread in this negativity, and then you get shot and die or anything like that, like, how do you think your family's going to feel? Like, now you're hurting your family. Your negativity has brushed up on somebody else, and now they want to take it out on you, and then your family is left feeling alone. And of course, not all deaths are people's fault, especially people that spread positivity. And I'm not knocking Pop Smoke, because but a lot of rappers bring negativity into the world. But I mean, and I know it sells, but as a listener, like, I can take some positivity. I could take some, like, I listen to Kendrick, Cole, all those kind of people. And it's just like, I mean, the positive stuff can sell as well. So why not be positive and still be happy? Like, spread positivity and you can still make money and still benefit from the positivity brought into the world. You never have to worry about anything. So, yeah, let's keep listening.
To mention only other factors, government agendas against rappers. They want to see us either dead or catch. So we hold our...
That's facts. That's facts, too. Because even when they were supposed to pop, when I think 5-0 was supposed to perform at Rolling Loud, the police told them that they essentially can't perform. And I guess if they performed, they wouldn't be allowed. They would probably shut down the whole festival just because they performed. And I'm pretty sure it was because of gang relations. But, like, so many... And it's a double-edged sword because, like, yeah, they may have been gang-affiliated, but there are multiple other musicians that are gang-affiliated. And nothing happens at the shows. So I don't understand why they would knock just them from coming and performing when multiple other people, even if they're not gang related, people, musicians can still have riots happen at their shows even if they're not gang affiliated. So that doesn't really make any sense either, but whatever. But yeah.
Head eye till they put us below. Rest until the day we die. We gon' keep this heat close. This is for my niggas who took a day to relax. Hugging the blacks, but the black ain't hug us back. So I keep my head eye till they put me below. Rest until the day I die. I'ma keep this heat close. This is for my niggas who took a day to relax. Hugging the blacks, but the black ain't hug us back. Yeah, I'm about to lay that shit.
Shit. Yeah, I like that. I like that for sure. I knew he was speaking facts, too. He was speaking facts. And it's just like, yeah, I understand why some of these rappers carry guns, but it's still like, you got to spread that positivity. That's all I'm saying. But other than that, rest in peace to Pop. I fuck with the Joey Badass freestyle and the Lil TJ song. And, yeah, it's sad to see him gone so soon for no reason at all. And I hope his family's okay. And, yeah, peace.